Pedro!
Tony!
We're in gaming!
And that's you!
Hello inmates and welcome back to the Unravel Courser Warshack, if you want to call me by my in-game name. We'll be continuing on by playing some Tempo Mage, well, at least it's the kind of Tempo Mage's deck, with our free-to-play account. For those of you who are new or just joining us, this account is completely free. We've never spent a dollar on the account. Everything has been earned by either completing quests, doing arena, and just all around just playing the game with, again, without spending a single US dollar. With that said, we are attempting to complete our mage quest. We need to win 3 more games with mage to get all the 2 quests we have done, and then we can hopefully fill in the rest of the remainder of the quest with stuff that we need to do in arena. Our current arena deck is Druid, which we will be doing in the next episode. Hopefully we can get 3 wins here, then we'll head over to arena, we'll build the Druid deck, we'll play a couple games in there, and that'll be great. There's a couple things I wanted to talk about that I forgot. I was like starting off with something, but then I figured I'd mention some stuff, and now I'm gone. So we're just going to talk about the game until I can remember. So this is a pretty damn good start, if I'd say. He's been able to kill our Mana Worm. And he played Argent Squire, and Argent Squire is pretty annoying to get through. But I guess we'll just ping down the Divine Shield, and we'll just end our turn here. Again, JV, thank you again for this new gaming chair. I know I mentioned it before, but it's so far been our largest donation, and it needs to be stated that someone loved the channel enough to go out of their way, like JV did, to ask, "What? Hey, what do you guys really need?" Obviously, he saw that we needed a... we need a new chair, and he did so. He donated the money for us to buy this chair, so again, thank you, man. Much appreciated. You will forever... Oh, and then all of our top donators, guys, I mentioned it in one video, like, I think a couple weeks back, but I thought I'll mention it again. On our About Me page on this YouTube channel, if you go to the About Me, it'll show all of the top donators. Not that we have a huge amount of donators or any of them are super high up there, but it just shows those who care more than others. I wouldn't say care more than others. Those who want to help the channel when they can and have the ability to. They're located there. So the guys definitely need to be recognized for all what they've done. All right, so Forgotten Torch, one of these. This becomes a 2-2, and then that just doesn't look good because then this swings into here and it's at 1 HP. But if we go ahead and do this, either way we're floating 1 mana, no matter what we do. So I guess we just Forgotten Torch and end turn, right? So we attack into here, it has 1 HP, but we actually want him to make this attack. So next turn we can just ping it down and we prevent ourselves from taking 2 damage. Unless he has like a Lightning Bolt. If he has a Lightning Bolt anyway, then we're just going to Farseer, and he's going to have to make the trade anyway, so. We'll see what happens there. I'm gonna do my best to post the free to play. I mean, I'm going to try. I don't know if this is gonna be set in stone yet, but I'm going to attempt to get a free to play every other day. Currently, we're posting them every 3 to 4 days, but I'm gonna do my best. See if I can get one every other day, and it'll be good. So on top of what we normally do. So it'll be one video every day, and then every other day, it'll be 2 videos, and it'll be free to play. But I'm not sure if I can do that yet, because I don't know if I have the time. Also, the fact that I can only render 1 video at a time with this laptop over here, and like I said, the whole process for a video takes along 4 to 5 hours for the whole entire process. So if I render 2 videos a day, which is normally I render out 2 videos a day, that's roughly 10 hours of computer downtime, and that's the time I'm awake. And before I go to bed, I can do it, but then I have to leave my computer on, and my room gets hot as fuck. And I really don't like waking up in like a sweat because my room is like fucking super hot. All right, so we know we're gonna make this trade, but then what do we do past there? I don't think we Arcane Select, and I don't think we Fireball. So I think we're just going to Azur Drake, see what we draw, and then we're going to make the trade into the Flame Tongue Totem. He definitely should have killed off our 3-3 with this Flame Juggler, because he was we had no way to kill the Flame Tongue Totem, so he could actually like maybe totem up and get a Taunt Totem, and then he could make the trade with our Azur Drake. But he gave us like a free trade into his Flame Tongue, which was kind of silly. But he has another Flame Tongue, so let's see if he makes the trade now. Maybe he'll learn from his lesson. He needs to kill this Flame Juggler into into the Farseer, but a better play would be to swing the Flame Juggler into the Azure Drake, and then swing his Totem Golem into our 3-3. And then he needs to totem up and look for a healing totem. Or he can just go with the Horse Rider and make a trade and not lose anything. Alright. So, I like the Fireball onto this, right? And then this needs to die, so we're just going to ping this down. And we could have Arcane Missiles, and hopefully all of them hit, but I don't want to trust Arcane Missiles to do that. I'd rather combo it with like an Azure Drake, so it can deal the additional 1 damage. Tunnel Trog is kind of scary, but not super scary. What's this last card in his hand? That's really scary. So theoretically, we absolutely need to draw a Fireball or a Polymorph here. If not, we cannot take 9 damage. Polymorph was the card to draw here. So how you doing? Now we could go ahead and play the Ooze, but I have to save that for when he plays the... this has to die, which means we have to... I guess we Arcane Missiles first and see how these land. If it kills the sheep... Alright, now we can... we can actually ping this, or we can draw 2. We ping this, we're only taking 5 damage. If we don't draw 2 now, there'll be no way to kill this. So it's like, what do I value more, drawing into a Flame Strike or pinging this off? I think I value killing this. I need to save health because we have a lot of spells that can kill the either one of these totems, but we have no way to get back health. So hopefully we just draw into some of our spells. It sucks that we draw into both of our cycles this early on. So we don't want to draw into cycle this early on because we need room to play spells or creatures. We don't have room to sit here and try to draw cards. And we just don't have the luxury to sit back and do this. So Roaring Torch is fine here. Any sort of spell to kill either one of these guys. Flame Strike is really, really good here. So we're just going to go Flame Strike. And then we're going to ping this down. Again, we could have played Acidic Swamp Ooze, but if he plays Doomhammer, we need to be able to get rid of that. I mean, even at saving as much health as possible with the plays we've made previously, it still might not be enough, because 16 health against a Shaman is not a lot. A couple turns, and he'll have the burst necessary to kill us. So it looks like we're going to Azure Drake into some cards, see what we get. Hogger's pretty good here. I actually like the Hogger a lot. And we're going to ping off the 1-1. We could have Arcane Intellect, but I like just killing off the totem in case he has Thunder Bluff. Because right now the Hogger contests the 3-4, and the 2-2 contests the Totem Golem if he doesn't want to waste his spell to get past it. I don't know why. It's like, it's not pollen season, because it's not summertime, but my nose has been horrible. Like, every once in a while, it acts up, and it's been horrible these past couple days. So we're going to Azure Drake to draw, see what we get. I was hoping for some sort of, like, Frostbolt or Roaring Torch to get rid of this Totem Golem. I think we're actually going to make the trade for it, but we'll go ahead and we'll Arcane Intellect, see if we can draw some more stuff. The more options we have, the better. We're actually going to... I guess we can ping the totem and then swing into here, and then killing off this. And now we can actually use the ping to kill the spell power or totem next turn if he doesn't have the healing totem to heal it back up. And we have a lot of resources in our hand. We have the additional Flame Strike, we have a Polymorph. I think this is where we're going to make our comeback. If he decides a Doomhammer, we never really had to play this Acidic Swamp Ooze, so we got resources there. I see what's happening here is probably going to be... I like the Flame Caller. I could have Flame Strike, but I actually would rather just save this. We know this goes into... Actually, can we save it in any way? Can actually draw. But then we don't really get to save the ping. So I actually like the Water Elemental a lot here. I like the ping here. I like this. And then I like that. And it makes a taunt. If he decides he wants to get a weapon, the Water Elemental is going to be able to freeze him. So the Acidic Swamp Ooze actually is not going to be that great this game, because the Water Elemental is going to do basically the same thing to just shut it down. But we didn't have the Water Elemental at the time, nor did we know we were going to draw into it when they were sick. Because he could have drawn into Doomhammer at any point in time. I'm actually just going to go ahead and Flame Strike this field to set up a 2-turn. But he actually might concede here. We'll actually draw, because it doesn't matter if we do one more damage. We have lethal next turn, no matter what. And there's the concede. Yeah, buddy. Hot diggity do. There is one quest done, so we just need two more wins with the mage. And then we'll have the, I did want to ask you something. Oh, boy. All right, I did want to ask you something. In my Miracle Rogue, I have Faceless Manipulator, Emperor for the combo with Leroy. I had to take out the Violet Teachers, though. Do you think that's okay? Problem is sometimes waiting for the combo, although you can win without it. Just wanted your opinion on whatever is better to have the Violet Teachers instead.
Jaina versus Rome.
All right, I'll answer his question after this video. So the reason I respond is because he has priority. He's a biggest donator. He deserves a response back. All right, so not the best starting hand. I was hoping for, of course, Mana Worm. We don't have Sorcerer's Apprentice yet, so we're actually going to have to craft those pretty soon. Because those go basically into every single mage deck besides Priest Mage. So very, very similar start to what we've seen before. Just going to ping down the Divine Shield. If we don't draw anything by turn, if we don't draw any three drops here, we'll Forgotten Torch whatever he decides to play. If he doesn't play anything, we'll save the Forgotten Torch. We might even go ahead and Arcane Intellect. I'm not really that scared of a 1-1. Yeah, so we're actually not even going to Roaring Torch here. We're just going to play the Chillwind Yeti. Actually, no, we can't play the Chillwind Yeti. I lied. So we draw, or we Forgotten. And I like, man, I want to kill that. Because the Flame Tongue Totem is bad, but I'm gonna draw. The ability to draw is so great because it gives us resources to deal with whatever the fuck he plays. Like drawing into Flame Strike is good. Having two Chillwind Yetis as like our beef guys is good. Him playing Totem Tuskar, what did he get? Healing Totem, not too bad. So we actually could go ahead and play the Mana Worm and then Roaring Torch this Totemic, which I like a lot. And this contests his field, but now I feel like he's just gonna Flame Tongue Totem, and then he can swing this guy, his squire, into the Mana Worm. My phone vibrated. I wonder if that's a Pokemon. I'm just kidding, I know it's not called Pokemon. But I call it Pokemon because it makes people cringe whenever I'm out. I'm like, you guys catching them Pokemans? And they're just like, it's Pokemon! I'm like, I don't know, but I'm just messing with you. Alright, Arcane Missiles is pretty sick here, considering three of the creatures he has out have 1 HP. But we know we're just going to Flame Strike in the coming turns, so I'm actually not sure if I really like the Arcane Missiles right now or not. Currently, he can't kill the Chillwind Yeti, and then if we Arcane Missiles and it just hits the Healing Totems, it's pointless. So I'm just going to save it for the Flame Strike. That dies the Flame Strike, and it looks like he Lava Bursted? Yeah. So we'll definitely kill the Tonitrog just because that's a lot of damage, or we might even ping off this Divine Shield, but then that tells them we have a Flame Strike more than anything. So we draw something with three, well, it depends what we draw. That's pretty good. We actually may not have to.
Can I light your fire?
We'll see what happens here. We may be able to conserve the Flame Strike. Hit the Tonitrog, not even once. Could've hit the Healing Totem, but it heals at the end of his turn, which means if he wants to make this trade, he's going to lose that card. And if he doesn't make the trade, then we can go ahead and just hit it next turn with the ping. We have the Polymorph, so I wasn't really scared of the 7-7. So we know we're going to ping. That's going to be 6 mana, and we're at 7, so this is basically, it takes up our entire turn. We're going to ping, and then we're going Polymorph this. And again, we're at that 16 HP. Or we're starting to turn around the game, so theoretically next turn's like Hog or Ping, depending on what he plays. The Hogger's a good defense. If he doesn't want to deal with it, he's going to have to use a spell. And that spell is one less spell. So there's the Doomhammer, so the Acidic Swamp just has to go down. So it's basically Hogger, Acidic Swamp Ooze. And then he probably just has the burst to kill me, but we'll see what happens. Let's see if Hogger is going to save our hopes and dreams here. What's up with all the aggro shaman? That's a lot. It's getting hot. Flame Juggler, we want this to hit anything but the taunt. That's fine. But now this actually dies the Lightning Bolt if he has it. Hopefully he doesn't have Lightning Storm either. But we also have the Flame Strike that we can combo with the Mana Worm. Alright, so it looks like, is he going to make the trade? He sure is, which is fine. So next turn is going to be Mana Worm, Flame Strike, clear the entire board, go face, make another taunt, and probably concede. As soon as we can start getting back that board, it's fine. And then killing the Doomhammer was critical. If we didn't kill the Doomhammer, we would have lost almost 100%. So no Harrison, we've got the Ooze though. The Ooze is good. There's the Lightning Bolt because the Flame Juggler hit this and you didn't need full healing totems. The Flame Juggler hitting this was bad, but it's better than us healing that taunt. Then we would have lost the taunt. So I guess we could go ahead and go with the Arcane Intellect first, or we go with the Azur Drake to draw. I like the Arcane Intellect first. Pyroblast is key. Frostbolt is good. So we actually go Azur Drake. Then we can go, Fireball is good, but we only have 2 mana left. So Frostbolt this. We're going to kill off our lower taunt creature. We're going to kill off this totem. And then next turn we have lethal. Theoretically, we should have maybe killed off the Acidic Swamp Ooze if we were scared of like him getting another Doomhammer Rockbiter, but it still wouldn't have mattered. You would have to Doomhammer double Rockbiter. You'd have to, Doomhammer Rockbiter spell into this spell face with only 3 cards. That's just not enough. We're just going to go face. We're not going to show him we have the Pyroblast or the Fireball. We'll just top deck the Roaring Torch. We'll just use that. Lose the win streak. Back to 16. I don't even know if we're at 16. But I know we lost a couple games in a row. Lost like 2 games in a row. So we'll win this one. We'll finish this quest up. We'll call it. And then we'll begin our arena series with Druid. And we'll see how well that goes. I'm not very skilled in the arena building of a Druid deck, but we'll do our best. We'll do our best with what we got. And then we also have to play on our main account. Yeah, I'll probably do that after this. We need to hit Legend for sure. I really don't like anything in this opening hand. Maybe keep an Arcane Missile just in case he's playing like aggro or some shit. Maybe slow down the board a little bit, but ideally we're looking for some of our early game creatures. Water Munch is okay, but I was really hoping for maybe a 3-drop or a 2-drop. Even if it's an Acidic Swamp Ooze, it's still a card to play. And I know the one time I don't check Audition, I'm not going to be recording or some bad shit's going to happen. Unfortunately, there's not a whole lot we can do in this particular turn. The Voidwalker shuts us down. If you would have played maybe something else, like a 1-1 that makes another 1-1, we would have got Arcane Missiles. He's playing maybe the Flame Juggler? Not Flame Juggler. Flame it? Or one of our teams? But not right now. We'll ping the 2-2. Get it out! Alright, so now we're gonna go ahead and we're going to Arcane Missiles, and then we're gonna go ahead and ping whatever's left over, and then just play the Water Elemental as it creates naturally. Or do we just play the Water Elemental? We have to coin into it. I like Arcane Missiles. Man. I was really hoping it would hit this 1-1. So I guess we'll just play Water Elemental. Oh boy. Well. I guess we're forced to play Water Elemental and we're taking at least 6 damage next turn. We need to put something on the board to start contesting these creatures. The problem is this deck isn't built to do that. Like, we have spells early game, we didn't really draw a whole lot of them. We drew Pyroblast, Azur Drake, Water Elemental, Arcane Intellect. Like, that's not... We drew Arcane Missile, but that's about it, guys. We did not get what we needed. And he's drawn a pretty fucking disgusting opener. So, ideally here... I don't even know what's good, but we definitely have to kill this. So we know this dies. And we don't have a fireball, which means we can either frostbolt this, and we can coin into Pyroblast, or we can just polymorph it. We frostbolt it for 3. That means we still have to do 2 more damage to it, which means we have to polymorph. We can actually coin ping, but the problem with coin ping is if we draw a flame strike next turn, we can't play it, and we need to be able to play it. So, drawing a flame strike next turn is absolutely crucial. Like, this is the point of, like, Zoo. They just play every single card in their hand, and if your opponent can't get rid of it, they win. And if you can, then it's fine. It takes them fucking 3 5-minute games. Like, this is just horrible. This is just a bad way to lose. I dislike it so very much. Alright, so we'll go. We had to kill that, that's no doubt. Then the Frostbolt has to go onto this so we don't take 5 damage. We have to Arcane Intellect, which we should have done before anything, but it doesn't really matter. There's the Flame Strike, but it's one turn too late, so we actually have to go ahead and coin to ping this. And how much damage is this? So 3, 4, 5, 6. So he only needs 3 damage, so we played around abusive by coining to ping. But it's not going to be enough. He just needs Power Overwhelming, Abusive, Doom Guard, Power Overwhelming, yeah. That's Zoo for you. We just didn't, like, we drew a lot of our late games, and he had Doom Guard. He had 2 Doom Guards. We're playing Zoo. We made a Zoo deck on this account first, just because of how cheap it is, right? But we don't, like, you haven't seen us play Zoo on this account in some time now. And the reason being is just, you hear me talk so much shit about it, I just don't like the deck. I'll play it, though, because we didn't like it. On a free-to-play account, it's totally fine. But when you're, like, rank 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, obviously you're not playing on a free-to-play account. And you can play other decks that require a little bit more skill. But at rank 16, it's fine. It's probably what the guy can afford, even though that was, I mean, he had... Seemed like he knew what he was doing. It's just so strange that people have such good decks at such low ranks. Not that this is extremely low, but like when I picture rank like 15 through 25, I picture like beginner players, like those players who have not even like similar decks to us, or maybe even a little bit below what we have. But it seems like we're playing against most people that have everything they basically need, minus maybe 5 cards in the deck. But we're running this mage deck, and we still don't even have Sorcerer's Apprentice. It could be my fault, though. Who knows? It's just interesting. I don't normally play at these ranks, so seeing what is played at these ranks, it's just interesting. Simply put. We're actually just going to go ahead and play the Acidic Swampoos here because he's a druid. He doesn't have any weapons. There's no point not to play it. We're not going to be saving it for anything. If we're playing against maybe a warrior, we probably would have still played it. So Wild Growth into Innervate into Emperor. Alright. So Polymorph's a good draw here. Flame Strike, not so much. So I guess we could theoretically kill it with what we have here. But I like frostbolting it first, or do we go ahead and miss it? I guess we're arcane. Alright, so I guess we kill it off, right? Hopefully that was his only big card. Hopefully we draw. Oh no, we have coin into the Hazard Drake. It's fine. It's good. It's good. It's good. All good. Wow, look at this guy. He's rank 1. Congrats. Gleb's rank 4. Fine. Swipe's pretty good, but I'd rather him swipe our 1 mana card than swipe our Hazard Drake. Base of Summoner's good. Unfortunately, we don't have another 5 drop. So ideally, this turn we want like a Chillwind Yeti, another Azur Drake, any Arcane Intellect would be fine. Force of Nature out of the Raven Idol is good for him. We can't really deal with this current board right now. That's not really the card we're looking for. We do, however, want to kill this. We're actually going to ping base. The reason being is the ping the 2-2 doesn't do anything. Both the cards on our field contest those 2-2, but the problem is Soul of Force. We're going to probably play Hogger next turn, because he already used a swipe, and as we know, druids don't have the best way to deal with, oh god. Oh, fuck. Well, I mean, arcane missiles and a pink would be the best, but if he doesn't have Soul of Forest, then that's just the best. So, as long as, if he doesn't have Soul of the Forest, then if he does, then he's just God. But he probably does. Why else would you run Whisper of the Old Gods? Such a good card if your opponent get rid of. That's why we play the flame caller. Yeah. Deal one damage to everything. That's why Warrior is so good. Ravaging Ghoul, Whirlwind, Revenge. But we were one turn off Flame Strike, or I would have definitely Flame Strike. Even though they're all 1/1s, he spent seven mana summoning a bunch of 1/1s. We'll spend seven mana destroying a bunch of 1/1s. Power of the Wild is good, but it's not a Soul of Forest. Oh god, is that Savage Roar? Is that fucking lethal? Oh yeah. That's 8. That's like 16. That's 28. Oh my god. We like it at 1 HP. Oh shit. No, that's lethal. So theoretically, using arcane missiles and pinging last turn was the best thing. But this was so much worse than Soul of the Forest. Like, what the fuck? Like, what the fuck was that? Rank 16 plays. Not even legend players do that. Oh my god, these gods. They're fucking gods among men. Oh, that is beyond me. Not even I.
Jaina versus Rexxar.
Like, the reason we didn't ping an arcane missile is because we had flame strike. So it doesn't matter how many we kill, we're flame striking the next turn. Like, if we didn't have flame strike, we're gonna keep the SA swappers. If we didn't have a flame strike, then we arcane missiles and ping. Because we have no way to deal with what he has and we need to limit the number. But the fact that we have flame strike, we're flame striking the following turn, no matter if he sold a force or not, because we have to deal with his board state. So theoretically, flame strike lost us the game. Because I would have killed as many as I could. We would have killed basically anywhere between 3 to 4 of them, depending on how our game was going. But yeah, that was just horrible. So it looks like a Tundra Rhino went to his hand. Alright. Do we Frostbolt or we Acidic? I like Frostbolt. So we Acidic now, it leaves us with having to, like, it's just, we don't have to play Acidic Swampoos next turn. Like, we draw Farseer, we draw Arcane Intellect, we draw other cards to play, we save this for the Eagle Horn. If he plays nothing here, and we don't draw anything to play, then we Acidic. Yeah, now we Acidic. I know that it's used for Eagle Horn, so theoretically, if he plays Eagle Horn Bow here and kills our Acidic Swampoos, we're extremely fucking sad. But it's one of those things where you have to just play it and go. Karen Grub is good, so Frostbolt's pretty good here. Arcane Intellect. I do not want to polymorph this because I need to save this for high main. But if we don't polymorph this, we lose board state. If he does play high main, we have Frostbolt, Flamestrike. I also have Azure Drake next turn. This is dead. He also could Houndmaster that, which is really bad. We have to use it. Not an option here. Non-negotiable. No refunds. Must die. Fireball would have been ideal there. There's the Eagle Horn. Ripping pajama bottoms. Weird he didn't play that before. There's a Fireball. At least his Eagle Horn doesn't kill our Azure Drake. Another Azure Drake draw is good. So Azure Drake and a Flame Strike or an Arcane Intellect and a Fireball, it's pretty good. This Azure Drake grants us another Polymorph. That's really good if he decides he wants to play High Main. We know he has the Tundra Rhino, so theoretically you go Tundra Rhino attack. It has 1 HP, Eagle Horn into it, then we ping it, and then Arcane Intellect, or we just go Azure Drake, maybe draw into an Arcane Missiles. So tracking, it looks like he's going for a 3 or 4 drop, so maybe Infested Wolf. Ping and then nothing. Wow. He probably has Savannah High Main in his hand. He thinks he's like, as soon as I play Savannah High Main, I'm gonna win the game! Savannah High Main power! Watch him play Savannah High Main. Ah, Sylvanas! Interesting pick, interesting card. Great. So let's go Arcane Intellect to the pocket. The reason we trade is because of Houndmaster. I know he can swing his Eagle Horn Bow into here, or this is going to take him to 15, and then we have two fireballs in our hand and a pyroblast. It's just a matter of time. We actually have lethal next turn. Yeah, we lethal. So this is going to be 14, and this is going to be... fun and interactive. Good stuff. 725 gold. Completed all our questicles. Druid or Hunter, you know what? Let's go have it play. No. Because we have a... No, it's 40 gold. We can get bigger than this. Play a friend and you both earn a reward. Who messaged me? I think Boss did, right? Boss man, yeah. You can play me, Boss man. I don't want to kick you. I actually have to kick you. Alright, so we'll leave off after Boss Man. We'll see if we can beat the Boss Man. He's one of the inmate. Oh god. Alright, good. I didn't actually. I just didn't mind. Standard game. What are we gonna play him with? Let's play him with some Miracle. We need to get better at Miracle. And he was also watching us play Mage, which probably makes him think we're gonna play Mage next. So we're gonna juke him. But yeah, Boss Man comments on a lot of our videos. He's a good guy. He's probably gonna watch this one. So what up, Boss Man? I need new comments in the chat. When I say comments in the chat, I'm talking about comments on YouTube. Again, guys, we do not stream. We get at least like 3 comments a day. Do you stream? And the answer is no. I do not stream. I do not have time to stream. And when we did stream, we actually streamed 4 days a week for 4 hours a day. The max viewers that we had was, I think, like, I streamed RuneScape and got 35 viewers. I streamed Hearthstone and got 4 to 7. So, yeah, it was not delightful. And not that it wasn't fun, it was just streaming for 4 hours to stream to 4 people, and in that 4 hours I could have made, like, 4 Road to Legends, I could have done 4 free-to-plays, it could have been a lot more time-productive. And it's not like we did it for only a week, like, we did this for, like, 5 months, and it didn't grow past about 7 viewers when we were playing Hearthstone. And it's not like we didn't post on our Instagram or Twitter either, it's like we did our best. It didn't work, and we cut it off there. You guys that recommend all these things for us to do, you gotta remember, it's just me, sometimes, and then there's Tony, and that's it. Like, Tony's like, he does 1 video a week. And not that that doesn't help, it helps a ton, but it's not, you need more, like, some of the recommendations you guys make. Not that we don't like recommendations, they're really great, but you just gotta keep in mind the scale of what we're talking about. It's just this is a one-man army. We don't have a team like, you know, Amaz and Trump and Crip has. Like, they've got people up the yin-yang doing shit for them. And then you've got us, which is me. That's it. There's no team. There's no huge sponsor in the background giving me billions. Not that they make billions, but you guys understand what I'm saying. Like, there's a lot more that goes behind the scenes with those guys than just them making the videos. Alright, so we actually have a pretty disgustingly not so good choice here. I think we're going to actually have to Abyss, swing, and then dagger back up. And the reason we killed this is because the dragon thing can be healed, as the Peacekeeper is basically always going to be a 3-3. This is also not the opening hand that we were looking for. Double Cold Blood Hogger is not exactly what we're looking for. Like, this is like the burst. This is a 14 damage burst combo, but it doesn't help us in the early game whatsoever. We got no backstabs. We have no Phantom Knives. We have no Violet Teachers. We didn't draw. Oh, there's our Phantom Knives. So I can't complain anymore. So we'll go Phantom Knives. Unfortunately, we can't combo it with anything, so we're just gonna, like, slowly but surely kill ourselves off with our own little dagger. So best card we could draw next turn would be maybe another SI, another backstab. A backstab would be good, but we're just backstab and then SI, and then we'd have to re-up our weapon. So what is it called? The strike thing, the deal 5 damage to an undamaged, that's our best draw. Sap is not too bad either, because then he would have to replay this. Or we could just go leave Hogger, but then that just dies. So I'm actually going to go ahead and return that to his hand, and we're going to kill that off. And we didn't attack with our weapon because we're most likely going to need that in case we draw like a deadly poison. So if he replays the Dragon Consort, It's going to cost him 3 to play a 5/5, and then we can actually just, if we draw a conceal, we're going to go double cold blood and just go face with everything we've got. It looks like he's going to go ahead and use the Truce Over to clear off our board. So we actually go Hogger here. Hogger's a great, this is a great time for Hogger. It gives us another 2 turns to draw. This is pretty good. He's going to kill off this 1/1 so he can't buff it. This 2/2 no will hopefully stop his True Silver from going through, and if he decides he wants to want to get 3, he's going to have to use Consecration, which means if he has a quality Consecration, he's not going to be able to kill our Concealed Auctioneer. The Ysera is good for him, but it's a little too slow. Like, we've got 14 damage combo here, so little does he know. Alright, so we're going to go Auctioneer, prep. Alright, we're not going to be killing this. So I think we go Evis Face to start it off. We can actually backstab this. It's free. I was hoping we'd draw another prep because then we can prep zap that, but this is good because unless he has a consecration, and then that's why we put it on the hogger. But I guess, no, we couldn't put it on the auctioneer because the hogger needed to go face, and the reason we use the cold bloods now is because we could draw with them. If we would have put it on the Leroy later, we wouldn't have been able to draw 2 additional cards. So there's the equality consecration. So we basically just need 1 damage. So, with this turn, we have to draw 1 damage. Actually, no, 4 damage. So, another Abyss does it, but we've already used 2 Abysses. So, what would we do? I don't know. Good question. This is Deadly Poison's one off. Oh, man, that sucks. So, I guess we go Azur Drake. This would be 7, 8, 9. Oh, no, that doesn't work. Yeah, so this is 6 and this is 3. That puts him at 9. I wonder. We go Fan of Knives. It puts this at 3. So we're actually going to have to Fan of Knives, sap that. And that's 5 mana. No, we should have Leroy'd first. Fuck. Fuck, fuck, fuck. Because then we could have Leroy'd Fan of Knives. And then he would have been at 4. Then we have him first. But either way, this goes back. This goes here. And then I guess we go. Do we go double deadly? We go double deadly. All right. Can you do 7 damage burst, Paladin? What is going to happen? Who is going to be victorious? He Harrison Jones and then plays the 3/6 taunt. All right. Emerald Drake doesn't stop him. Lay on hands. Forbidden Healing, heal for 15. We are currently 4 damage off lethal again. We are now 2 damage off lethal. Because this is 11. Yeah, fuck, we're 4 off. What do we do? Well, we know Leroy's going to have to come down to kill that Drake. So, do we Leroy? Yeah, I think we have to Leroy face. We have to Leroy into the 7/6. This has to go here. So we can Azur Drake. Are we SI agent? So SI agent, swing face, re-dagger, or do we... I think we have to Azur Drake. And then I think we have to go face. Oh, man. The Forbidden Healing fucked me. So did the True Silver. We were 1 damage off. So it was the turn that we didn't Leroy, when we could have attacked with Leroy. Yeah, we could have attacked with Leroy and then the Phantom Knives. I think this is the end, unless we have the ability to do 10 bursts, but our Leroy's gone, our double cold blood's gone. I think this is it. The end. Backstab, it just doesn't do it. This is 3, this is 5, and this is at 9. We're at 5. Yeah, this is the end. That minion well played. That's the extent we've lost. Miracle down. Miracle is down. Yeah, I just couldn't seem to draw those violent creatures. I want to put in a questing adventure, but we don't have it yet. So we gotta kind of just wait patiently. Watch him be quality just for the troll to kill off everything. Inequality kills his own board, like equips true silver champion and just goes to base. Alright, so we got 80, and then what else? That's it? It says you and your friend. So it's just 80 gold and that's it? I mean, I don't care, 80 gold's a fuck ton. Play a friend, you both earn a reward. I did play a friend. Why do I still have the quest? Why is it still here? Play a friend, you both earn a reward. Maybe it'll go next time we log in. I'm gonna log out and log back in. If it's still there, we're gonna play another friend. We're gonna play as many friends as we got. 80 gold, we'd be raining the money. Best deals in town, folks. All right, so as always, guys, I'm Warshack, of course, and happy whatever the hell day it is.